Alright, so we're taking a look at diastasis recti, checking here, and my current patient is 20 years postpartum. Alright, 20 years postpartum. Go ahead and pick your head up for me. So 20 years postpartum, she's got a 2.5 finger diastasis gap going on, okay? Head back down, lift again here. Good, and this is about a 2 finger gap up here. Alright, so this is 20 years postpartum, diastasis recti is still gapping. We're working on fixing that, and we're changing how her body fires and how her body loads transfers. So we've been working on breathing and getting her ribs knitted together. So if you will, nice big inhale, ribs good, belly perfect, and then give me a nice exhale, knit those ribs, knit, 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 all the way down, good. Hold that for me and lift your head again. Completely gone. I can't even get one finger in there anymore. Diastasis is completely gone. So we worked on load transfer, perfect, head down, thank you. We worked on load transfer, getting her abs to actually fire correctly. So instead of all of her abdominal exercises have been kind of wasted and she's been getting chronic back pain, which is what she came to see me for. So basically, all of her abdominal work has not been effective at all because her rib cage has stayed flared. So getting those ribs in, knitting her diastasis together, now we just have to get her to own it and then use it all the time. And then it's gonna help completely relieve all of her back pain.